In the last lesson, we saw the main configurations of the operator panel and the menu select button. Today, we'll continue to see other buttons that make up the Siemens panel, and we'll make sure we don't leave anything behind so that we have a complete and in-depth knowledge of the control. So let's not waste any more time. I'm Paraday, he is Paolo, and this is CNC, of course. Even if you are seeing the Siemens 840D control for the first time, you will quickly realize that the main interactions with the control are through soft keys. Yes, Paolo, soft keys. Soft keys are the bar of buttons that you will have seen change meaning as soon as you select one of the various menus. We can have horizontal soft keys, which are at the bottom of the screen, and vertical soft keys, which are at the side of the screen. To click on a soft key, you will have buttons just below the screen. Or if you are working on a workstation with a touch screen, then just press your finger on the respective soft key. The number of soft keys in the horizontal bar could be 8 or even more, depending on the size of the screen. In fact, on some screens, Siemens may need to show more soft key series because they wouldn't all fit on one level. So if we're looking for a function, it may be in a second soft key series. In practice, we can rotate the entire soft key bar to display the other 8 or more soft keys in two ways. For horizontal soft keys, just click on the arrow to the right. Or if you are on sinew train, you can click on the little arrow just above the bar. For vertical soft keys, when there is a second set of soft keys, this icon will appear on the last vertical soft key at the bottom. Pressing it, it will switch between the soft key series. In fact, we see that pressing the switch icon will show the arrow once to the right and once to the left. What is it, Paolo? Of course, Paolo, that's a rightful concern, but don't worry too much. The first few times you use the control, it will be a bit difficult to find the button you need. But at least you know that if you look for a soft key and you don't find it, you can always try changing the series of soft keys and maybe you will find it. And don't worry, Paolo, because during the course, we will see the buttons and menus many times. So in the end, you will not have these problems anymore. Let's now take a look at the main buttons that we will need to move within pages and inside the same page or inside and outside cycles. Obviously, the arrows will be the most frequently used buttons. So in addition to the up and down arrows, which don't need much explanation, special attention needs to be paid to the right and left arrows, which are extremely useful for Siemens. As well as scrolling through a sentence, the left and right arrows are also used to enter and exit programs or cycles. Pay particular attention when you find the right arrow icon at the end of a line. It means that pressing the right arrow will open the program or the relative cycle. While pressing the left arrow will close it. Let's try to do it together by opening sinew train. To see the function of the arrow keys, we can go to the program manager by clicking directly on the program manager icon, or we could have done it through the main menu by clicking on menu select. Once opened with all the folders and the programs, moving with the up and down arrows, we will move between the folders or the files. While pressing the right arrow of the keyboard or of the Siemens keyboard, we will open the folder. If instead we go on a program, we will open the program. If it is an ISO file, we will have the whole sequence of ISO instructions. And we will move within the program itself with the up and down arrows. Or if I want to move faster, I will use page up or page down. To close the program and return to file management, just go to the first line and press the left arrow. So, right arrow to enter and left arrow to exit. Let's go back into the program. To exit the program, there is also the vertical soft key close, which is located in the second series of the vertical soft keys. Let's go back in with the right arrow and see that there are some blue blocks. These blocks, or for now we can call them lines, are cycles whose data are inserted using the data entry masks. For example, this line defined with the name workpiece is used to define the dimensions of the raw workpiece, useful to see the graphical simulation. We see that if we go to the line of the cycle, an icon appears with the arrow on the right. In fact, to enter the mask, just press the right arrow. Pressing the left arrow will close the mask, saving the data as well. Let's try to open a shop mill or shop turn program. Then go back to Program Manager, and now let's open a shop mill program. Also in this case, right arrow to enter the program, scrolling on the various cycles of the program, right arrow enters the cycle. To close the cycle, I could use the Cancel soft keys to close without saving, or Accept to close by saving the changes made to the cycle. To close the cycle saving it, I can also press the left arrow. Finally, to close the program again, just move to the first line of the program and press left arrow. In the middle of the four arrows, there is another important button, the Select one. This button has the important function to select the different possible options of a specific field. So if, for example, we are within a cycle in which we have to fill in the various data, as in this case we are within the drilling cycle, each field in which you will have the ability to select multiple options. Just click directly with the mouse on the field to switch between the various options, or by pressing the Select button. Alternatively, if I wanted to expand the drop-down menu of the field, I could use the Insert button to see the entire list of options. Well, Paolo, good question. Sometimes you ask me very interesting things. A good eye will have noticed that when I moved from one field to another, the description appeared, and in some cases there was also a symbol at the bottom of the description, exactly like the one in Select. Here's how to tell if there are more options when you find that symbol at the bottom of the description. Insert and Input are two apparently similar but very different buttons. Input corresponds to the Enter key on the keyboard, so it is the key that is used to start a new paragraph when we are inside the program. Input is also used to confirm an inserted field and move on to the next one. Insert, instead, is used to modify the field. Let's make another example. If we are inside a cycle and we are navigating in a field to insert some new data, as for example, the position of the retraction plane of a drilling cycle, you just need to go in the field, write the new data, and then press Input to confirm the field, or to scroll with a down arrow. But if you only want to modify the data without overwriting it, you can press Insert. The cursor is inserted into the already written value so that we can modify this value. To confirm, press Input again or the down arrow. Let's now see a new button, essential for operational matters more than programming ones, the Alarm Cancel button. As its name already says, Alarm Cancel cancels the present alarms. Sometimes, some alarms connected to the machine or to the numerical control can appear. A low liquid level or a programming error can be eliminated with the Alarm Cancel button, only in the case the reason that has triggered the alarm has been solved. Paolo, what's the matter? Are you hungry? Now I understand what you're saying. The Alarm Cancel symbol looks like a sandwich. In fact, many people call it the sandwich button. You will click on the sandwich button not when you're hungry, but when you want to cancel the alarm without using the reset button. One of the greatest features of the Siemens 840D control panel is that it can manage different channels. Let's imagine these channels as if they were different numerical controls in the same control. Paolo, what I mean is that there are machines in which there is a need to move different parts, almost independent of each other, with axes that are independent of the other channels, perhaps even with different axis names and with different programs that may also be running simultaneously. This is the case, for example, of multi-spindle lathes, where each spindle has its own axes with its own channel, or for some milling machines, some manufacturers set up auxiliary services such as tool change, with controlled axes that take care of depositing the tools in the tool magazine or bringing them to the work area. Click on the Group Channel button to switch between channels. One button that is often overlooked is the Help button. Because we often spend a lot of time looking for information in Siemens voluminous paper manuals when we have them available directly in the machine. By clicking on the Help button, the manual for the currently selected field will be displayed. If, for example, I am in a cycle, I can press Help for information about that cycle. Here too, I can see if a field has several options that can be selected with a Select button. For example, if I go to the Machine status by pressing the Machine button, I can see all the active G functions. And clicking on any function that is active at the moment, such as the FFWAF function, clicking the Help button, I will find the explanation. Once the manual is open, I can go and navigate to the other pages of the Siemens manual. To close the manual, press the Help soft key. Good. That's all for today. Paolo and I invite you to try immediately what we have seen together in this lesson. That's all for me and Paolo. We'll see each other in the next lesson.